Do about 3,000 more of those, then you'll be done. You know, this season's football strike has affected a lot more than players. Take the cheerleaders, for instance. Tonight we're going to pay a visit to a group of them. They're the swashbucklers, and they're the hot cheerleaders that help support the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Now, if you think the players stay in good shape, wait until you see these ladies. And we're going to find out there's more than pretty faces behind all those pom-poms.
Professional football is one of our country's favorite spectator sports. It's a contest between some of the biggest, fastest, toughest men to be found. Traditionally, pro football players are national heroes who are cheered by millions of fans. And in recent years, by dancing cheerleaders. But these cheerleaders aren't your timid high school variety. They're entertainers and team promoters and have become celebrities in their own right.
And the experience is unbelievable to have people, you know, wanting to photograph, you know, wanting your autograph and wanting to just, you know, say hi, you know. It's like...
Every Sunday, these lovely ladies adorn the sidelines and often attract as much attention as the football players. The cheerleaders love it, and the crowds love them. NFL cheerleader is fun and glamorous, but it is also a lot of hard work for little pay.
Let your arms balance your body. Keep them down. Press down as you kick, and you won't lose your balance. Kick behind your arms.
We visited the swashbucklers, cheerleaders for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, during a practice session, and learned...
It's not as glamorous as everyone thinks.
Patty Bean is the choreographer and director of the group.
Once you get to know these girls and what they do and what's involved and how much time they put into this, you find out that it's an awful lot of work and that these girls are just like anybody else. They're just down-to-earth people that want to get involved in a community organization and work hard.
Yvette Quintera joined the squad in January and realized right away cheerleading is no piece of cake.
When you've been all day working or out and had things to do and you have to come to practice, you know, for 2.5 hours or whatever we practice, it can get rough because, you know, you get tired of dancing all the time, but you have to be real dedicated, and if you want it and that's what you like, it's, you know, it's bearable.
The swashbucklers practice twice a week, year-round. During the football season, there are games on the weekends, of course, and there is always promotional work to be done.
The promotions start, I was really surprised. They start from the minute you make the squad, you start working, you know, and everything starts from then. I've done some parades, and we've been to Disney World, did some promotions in Disney World.
We do a lot of different promotions that you really wouldn't think about. I just done one for an electric company.
Practices, games, promotions. One would think these girls are paid well for their trouble.
They're not paid for games. They're not paid to come to practice. This is strictly on a volunteer basis. However, there are some promotions that they are paid for, and we have a fee of $30 an hour.
So, besides cheerleading, most of the swashbucklers have full-time jobs.
I'm with Secretary 3, and I'm employed at the Unemployment Appeals Office.
I'm going full-time to University of South Florida, and this is going to be my second year, and I have a part-time job, too.
I'm an executive secretary.
I work at a life insurance company, and I also model for a professional modeling agency, and I work part-time for Hugh Blind Liquors.
I teach fifth grade.
A school teacher?
My students think it's really neat. They come in and some of them get to go to the games, but most of them, their parents will go and they'll come home and they'll say, oh, I saw your teacher today. And they'll bring a program or something with my picture in it and the kids will bring it to school. And they think it's really neat. I have to be kind of careful though because I try to keep it kind of low key because I do want them to think of me as a teacher also.
Okay, they're fast. You got it. There's a rhythm to it. Defense. Defense. All right? All right, let's try it. 5, 6, 7, 8. Defense! Defense! Defense!
These girls give up a lot of precious time to be cheerleaders, so there must be a good reason.
You do it because you want to do it, not because you're expecting any reward as far as getting a pay or a salary, but because it's fun and it makes you feel good to do that.
My mom, my dad are so proud of me. They just brag all the time.
I've always wanted to cheer. I've been dancing all my life, and it really is more of a dance line than, you know, a cheering line, and I've just always wanted to do it.
personal satisfaction knowing that you, there are so many routines that you have to learn, and those cheers, and you gotta get them good, and you gotta get them right. And then you do it, and that feels good. Oh, it's tough, but it's so rewarding.
Cheerleaders on this squad, but only 28 dance at each game. However, there doesn't seem to be any competition between the girls. In fact, many told us the best part about being a swashbuckler is making new friends. And though practices are long and hard...
How many girls do you know that can say, yeah, I've been on television, and yes, I was an NFL cheerleader, and it's not too many. I still can't believe it sometimes, NFL cheerleader.
Strike or no strike, the swashbucklers say they've been keeping plenty busy. They work out twice a week, and they've had a very hectic schedule of public appearances. You might watch for them the next time Tampa Bay plays on TV, whenever that might be. Yet to come on PM, we'll tell you about the rest of our week. There's more health and fitness in store for you, and we'll be right back to tell you all about it.